Hey everybody, it is Margaret, Texas Gal Treasures, and I am here doing another reseller, Destash. Hang on, let me come over here and make sure I'm muted. Okay, I did. Good, good, good. Hello everybody, how's it going? It's been a couple days. The holiday season has been crazy pants. Crazy, crazy pants. So hopefully things are going well with you guys and that you're busy and safe and everything. So I have been clearing out my workroom because I'm really, 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 really downsizing what I'm selling. And so I am taking my stuff and selling it off cheap. I've got some really good boxes for this time because I'm starting to slash inventory. I'm really, really, really downsizing, especially now that we're going to be homeschooling as well. If you're playing the let's take a shot every time Margaret says homeschool, get your bottle ready. We started homeschooling, so I really have to reevaluate what I'm going to sell and how I'm going to work everything. And so jewelry is going to be the way for me. And so a lot of my really cool stuff is going to come out to you in the world. So I've got six boxes today, three large flat rate and three medium flat rate. The large flat rate are going to be 40. That includes the shipping, everything. And then the medium flat rate is 30. And that includes the shipping too. So in jewelry, what I've started doing with some of my jewelry destash is that I started selling like mystery boxes, kind of like a mini jewelry jar on my Etsy shop. And they're 20 bucks. And then you pay the shipping because I'm putting them in like a padded flat rate. It ends up being like a dollar or less a piece because I put 20 pieces. Between 20 and 30 pieces, depending on how big it is. I don't know. So I get 20 in there, and if it doesn't look like enough, I stick some more in there. So that's how that works. So yeah, if I put the link for that down below if you're interested in the jewelry ones, because I figured that would be a better way to maneuver things. So without further ado, I'm gonna start with these two that are on the floor. The first two are medium flat rate, and they're fabric lovers. The first one is all like toile, if you know what toile is. This is toile. So this is like blue toile. And so the whole box is, it's not all like huge pieces, but if you're quilting, you may just need like small bits, smaller. So there's lots. I'm gonna pull it all out so you see what you get. So this is a whole stack full of more toile. I mean, it's just, yeah, it's full of it, full of it. I'm pulling out more. Don't fall. So here's some more. Lots and lots of toile. You could do a toile lot. I don't know. Isn't that a funny word? I think it's French. Anyway, so that's the toile box. And get back in there. So that's 30 bucks, including this. That includes the shipping. The next box has like bigger pieces of fabric. It's really pretty too. Okay, I'm going to put this down here. Come here. Get the rest of it in there. Hey, Maggie. Hey, Carol. Hey, Margaret. How's it going? Okay, so the next, oh my gosh, I'm so heavy. I can't lift it with one hand. Okay, next box, we've got this huge, which is also kind of a toile, isn't it? Huge piece of fat. I mean, look at this. I mean, there's got to be, I'm guessing, more than 4 yards there. It's huge. But it's gorgeous, right? It's really pretty, kind of blue-green and like an ivory sort of color. Huge amount. And that brand, if you know fabrics, this is Moda, which is a really nice fabric maker, Moda. And then the rest of it, I believe, is also Moda. But it's all coordinating. So it's this blues. Like, if you were going to make a quilt, that could be the backing, huh? So then you got more of this. And this is all, again, that's not Moda. Yeah, it is Moda. Okay. Moda fabric. And then there's some that has like a lot and some that's like maybe a yard or so, yard and a half maybe. So those are my fabric boxes. Very cool. That's a lot of fabric. If you know fabric, you know 30 bucks is a good price for that. So hang on. I'm bonking it. Hey, somebody just popped in. Hey, Kayla, how's it going? I'm selling the stuff. Hey, 22 viewers, thanks for coming. Okay, so that's going back in there. I was debating today. I was either going to do a jewelry jar or I was going to destash. And destash one. Maybe I'll do a jewelry jar later, right? Moda's a great brand. It is. It's really soft, really good quality. Okay, since we're doing the medium flat rate, we'll do the next medium flat rate. Okay, so this one, honestly, I can't remember what I threw in here because I was just like, this box, this box, this box. Okay, so let's see what's in there. I'll unpack it and show you. I've got a cool stamp that says captured. There goes my clock. This one, yeah, stamp pad with a cap. What does that mean, captured? Hey, Julie! Then I've got a tin, and this is a vintage tin. So, you know, they make reproduction ones, but this is a vintage one. Edgeworth sliced pipe tobacco. It's got some pins in there. Bonus pins. So that is a vintage tin. Hey, hey! We have a Croft and Barrow wallet. So, what else is in here? That's a set. Hang on. I'll hang those, put those to the side because they're a set. Then we've got, this is a pen. It's a Bradley. Is it a pen or a mechanical pencil? One or the other. I can't remember. Mechanical pencil. There we go. Very cool. Fine writing instruments in the box. And then we've got these. This is Hallmark keepsake ornament. This is from Wizard of Oz. The brain, the heart, and the nerve. Very cool. What are those little mini ornaments? Hello, lady reseller Terry Berry. Hi, Debbie. Hey, hey. No, Margaret. You mean the fabric? No, that's actually part of her destash. She's been destashed. You don't understand. This is, my mom has so much fabric. Okay. Yeah, no. No, she's got a lot. Okay, then we have this beautiful ornament of the Holy Family. And this is a Kirk Adler, that is, ornament. And let's see what else. I'm trying to get this set. I have a set. There's one more of these copper measuring cups. So, like, this is 3/4 of a cup. This is a cup. There's one more in there, these little copper. It's in there. I'll find it. There it is. And then this really cool bowl, like a turned wood bowl. It needs a little cleanup, but it's good to go. I've made some good money on these kind of bowls. No, no, no. There's the other one. Hey, hey, Jenny. And then another wallet, like so, and it's Dante brand. What does that say? Carpincho pig. Is that good or bad? I don't know. Okay. Hello. All right. And then we've got a Campbell Soup Kid. And that is a tattoo that I've forbidden my husband to get. If you want to laugh, here we go. My husband says he wants a tattoo on his backside of a Campbell Soup Kid saying, good. I think he does it just to drive me crazy because he's never done it and we've been married for almost 15 years. I think he just says it because I'm just like, what? No. Yeah. I hope he's not serious. He hasn't been yet. So, okay. Next is a teeny weeny address book, vintage little address book. Oh, you know what? I'm not putting that in there because this is written in. So scratch that. That's not going in. Whoop. All right. Then next we've got this. It's an ashtray, and it's a Goodyear tire ashtray, like so. It looks like a tire. Hello, hello. And we've got this beautiful little box that's like inset. Oh, what is that called again? What is that called? You guys know. It's that mini mosaic, but there's a word for it. Isn't that pretty? Yeah, so there's a teeny little box, like so. That tattoo would be a bummer. My little black book, Maggie. Yeah, you have to pay a lot more than $30 to see in my black book. No, I'm kidding. Hey. Okay, and then, oops, wrong side. So this is like an umpire thing, like strike ball out, kind of doodad for baseball. Yeah, there's that. Inlaid, micro mosaic. There we go. And then we have a thing for... it's for lettering. Oh, okay, I know what it is. So you trace it and it makes it like bigger or smaller, right? One of those things. And there's another one. This is a letter scriber. So another one. So in the box, back in the box, you. I also have in here a really cute, is that one box? That's all one box. Card holder with little flip-flops and sunglasses. I think there's a stone missing out of there. My eyes are, yeah, there's a couple little stones, but that's cute. You can use it. And then some, oh, this is another Wizard of Oz. and it's still sealed, but it's these coasters, right? Wicked Witch coasters. Are you a good witch or a bad witch? So that's in the box too. So that is, let's see, we have two fabric boxes. We'll call this the last medium flat rate box. There we go, micro mosaic, that's it, yes. Okay, so that's that one, that's 30. Everybody back in. And if you're interested, what you'll do is either send me an email at gmail.com or send me a message on Facebook. Hey, Pamela from East Tennessee, how are you? Is it cold? We finally got a cold front in. Okay, so there's that one, all going back in. There, okay, so now for the large flat rates. I told you guys what to do. Yeah, email me or send me a message. All right, large flat rates are 40. If I can get this one up here. Okay, it's heavy. The mailman's not gonna like it. That's okay though. The medium flat rates are going for 30, and that includes the shipping, and the large flat rates are 40. I have a feeling the large ones are gonna go pretty quick when you see what's in them. Okay, so first up, I've got this set of French coasters with all the little animals on them. They're really cool, like so. Really cute, and the brand on those is Pimpernel, which is a really good brand for coasters and like placemats and stuff. We have, we go from high society to low society. We've got, it's like a cardboard little record, Mad Twist Rock and Roll, Twist Rock and Roll. Anyway, so it was probably like an insert in Mad Magazine. I don't know where I don't know. And then we've got a Disney trivet that's got a Mickey Mouse on it. That right there will sell a new. Nasty Rainy, oh, is it closing? Okay, and then we've got this owl like tea towel, like kind of like a bark cloth tea towel. Very cute. Some more coasters, and these ones have some ships. This is also Pimpernel, which again is like a really good brand. Let me check these out. Oh, they all have different ships. Some of them might need a little wipe down. I wanted to check that for you. But they all look pretty good, pretty good, pretty good shape, like so. I hope you guys are having a good holiday season. Your family's not driving you nuts. Then we've got these two little, I guess they're kind of like tea towels. I remember when I got these, I thought they were so funny. This one is a little dog. He's ready for that drink. Drank. And then this one's like a moonshiner. I like him. Anyway, so those are in there. I don't know, what would you call those? I mean, I guess you could hang them in your bar. I don't know. They're cute. Okay, this is really nice. This was one of those I was tempted to keep to sell. So it's leather and it's, what do you call it? When they, you know, pressed, right? Hello, Lydia. I started about 15 minutes ago. I've gone through three boxes so far. And if you look it up, this brand, this Oberon Designs, they have like a catalog and a website. It's like a checkbook type holder. It's really nice. Yeah, it's totally leather, really nice. Oh my gosh, now I'm having second thoughts. No, leaving it. I mean, you know that leather smell? Yeah, I'll just put that right there. That good leather smell, right? Okay, then we've got some author's card game. We have another wallet. This one's not as fancy. It's a chain wallet with a butterfly and a skull for some girl. Oh, you would frame the tea. Aren't they cute, right? And then this is like a Paul Frank something. I guess it used to be for like a cell phone. Maybe you would hold your cell phone in there. I'm not sure. I liked it. And Paul Frank's a good name. And it's not the normal pattern. So maybe it's something. Kentucky Derby koozie, right? And in that same vein, we've got a fox hunt tin. I love images of fox hunts. I don't know why. I know it's cruel. Same thing with bullfighting. Like, I love the artwork that people do for bullfights, but I'm like, it's horrible. Like, the sport is, you know, brutal and, hey, Nick and Andrea. Same thing with fox hunting. But I love, like, paintings of it. Is that weird? I don't know why. I don't know. Hey. Okay, next is some roulette-type cards. I don't know if they're regular cards or roulette cards. How does that work? Oh, they're roulette cards. I don't know how you play that. Yeah. Hey! Okay, who else we got there? Yes, embossed. Y'all, keep me honest. This is going in the box. What do I need with that? Okay, then we've got an, this is like an olive fruit, probably. Wine cork opener. Hey, Chili Serrano. Yeah, long time no see. And then this was a thing that I think we never could figure out what it was for. It's a vase, but I think we would hang it on the car window to enjoy lovely flowers in the car. Did we ever figure out what it was for? I don't think we did. But anyway, it's an oddity for sure. It's cool, right? So that's in the box. And then I've got a bunch of these like miniature, like this is a little sewing machine. Does that thing work? Does it go up and down? I think it's supposed to go up and down. I'm not sure. This is a Le Creuset card holder. And Le Creuset is a fancy schmancy brand, if you don't know Le Creuset. Then we've got another little piano like that. It opens the key. Yeah. I used to have one of these that was like a pencil sharpener. This one is not a pencil sharpener. Maybe they hung on a tomb. Oh my gosh, that might be it, huh, Margaret? It would be a small tombstone. You know, I mean, all the ones I've seen have been really big. Maybe it would hang there, though. Possibly. I didn't think about that. That's kind of macabre, but hey. Maybe. Okay, this came off. Let's put this back on. How do you go? It's another one of these miniatures. That the, it's a fan. Can you get back on there? I'm sure it'll go back on because it was on there. Aha. So we've got a little fan. That's cute. I wish it would go around, though. Anyway, cute little fan. There, but wait, there's more. There's a cash register. Oh, does it open? That would be so cute if it like a jack in the box and it cha-ching came open. I think it does open. Yeah, it does. Ah, Merry Christmas, everybody. That thingy looks old. Yeah, for a horse buggy. Yeah, could be. And then, okay, this one is a pencil sharpener. It looks like a little lantern with a pencil sharpener in it. Hi, hi. We have an Empire State Building bottle opener keychain from New York. But wait, there's more. Oh my gosh, this is all $40. We have some Trolls fabric, more fabric. We have some Rainbow Bright fabric. These are the cut and sew ones. We've got another one of these. I guess that thing comes off. This moves, this is kind of cool. What is that? Here, I'll hold it up so you can read it. Maybe I can read it better in here. So that's the brand, made in Hong Kong. So you know it's vintage, right? It's not just made in China. And that opens up like so. It's pretty cool. Oh, because this thing opens and closes. And you can lock it up. That's cool. Okay. No regrets. No looking back. No looking back. Then we've got some, we've got this little brass bird and this little brass bird. There's more brass in here. Hang on. We've got an armadillo. Got me an armadillo. Right there. And a cute mouse, like so. And an eagle or a hawk, very patriotic. And he's standing on a, I guess, it, well, let's make it a rock, even though it kind of looks like a bottom. But okay. And an elephant. Very cool, his trunk is up, so that's good luck. And finally, this one I know is vintage. It's Mickey. It's a Disneyland Mickey Mouse figure. And on the back, Walt Disney, what does it say? Walt Disney Productions. Isn't that cool? This is another one. I was so tempted to keep it, but I was like, no, I am sticking to jewelry. I'm going to have to do it. It's either coming to you or it's going to redonate. Okay, everybody back in. Stuff box. That one is $40. $40. Send me a message, Lydia, if you're interested. Okay, everybody back in. I gotta see. Oh, I got him. How did I get them in there? Because some of this I have to wrap up. Oh boy. I can't just send it. We'll figure it out. Get back in there. Yeah, the large ones are 40. And here, okay, this one's coming back under here. Down. There we go. Okay, got two more large flat rates. Hey, 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 Peter. Happy holidays. Do you guys know what you're getting for Christmas? Or do you, is it a secret? Or do you get something for Christmas? I don't know what my husband got me, but I know what my mom got me. because I asked for it. I wanted an Instapot. I keep hearing the shipping is included because the shipping is whatever it is for a large flat rate. Yeah. We ordered too much inventory. Our loss is your gain. I don't know. Yeah. You know, the mattress commercial. Okay, so next one, same deal. Large flat rate's $40. It includes the shipping, so it's just like a straight, I'll send you a PayPal invoice. Okay, so first app is, are you getting cold? Did I say that? Oh, Instapot. I wanted an Instapot. So I asked my mom, like, Mom, I really want an Instapot. That's what I want. So she's got me an Instapot. I don't think she's going to even wrap it. Okay, so we've got two, these are vintage, because I know they were my brother's, and he doesn't want them. So they are Spider-Man, and their outfits come off and everything. Not that I'm undressing Spider-Man. Don't ask. And then, oh, no, sorry, Julie. You have two Instapots, Kayla? I can't wait to start, like, you're going to start seeing Instapot recipes on my channel. Okay, I've got this cool wooden box. This actually was mine, but I just don't need it anymore. It's a nice pencil wooden box. I think it's got Thoreau. Yeah, Emerson. It's got a quote from Emerson on there. So there's that. A few friends and family. Secret, you always order gifts. Oh, nice. Yeah. It was tough because my mom didn't know what to get me either. And finally, I just said, just give me an Instapot. Okay, so these are, they're little wallets. I mean, they're a little bit worn, but they're still cool. Maybe somebody likes their wallets kind of broken in. And they're thin, kind of thin. Here's another one. It's like a money, this one's kind of like a money clip and holds your cards. That one's in pretty good shape. There we go. There's that. Yeah, I joined that. I already joined the Instapot community, even though I don't have one. Is that weird? But I'm planning. I'm planning. I can't wait. Okay, so next up, Randy says this goes to some kind of cleats. I don't know. The replacement parts and keys for some kind of cleats. I have a little elephant, which I think it's either like a trinket tray or ashtray. I think it's an ashtray. It's cute. I've got some more brass. These ones are deer. Some deer brass ones. I have this clock in here, like so. I can't remember if it worked or not. Big Ben Twilight is what it's called. There's that. Yes, I am, Nick. And Nick, he says, this is old stock. I am. I'm trying to just, like, I have so much stuff. And now that I'm homeschooling, take a shot. I just don't have time. I know I'm not going to ever get to it. So it's like, okay, I can just make somebody else happy. Right? This is a good box, too. Okay, so here we've got this pewter unicorn sitting in a swing under a crystal ball. There's that. And then we have this vintage Lisa Frank. Don't tell Jason. Because he was like, just send it to me. I'll sell it for you. Nope, nope. So vintage Lisa Frank stuff. And this bag is full of more, like, Lisa Frank doodads. So that's cool. It's not the new Lisa Frank. I've learned that the capital L and capital F is the thing, right? You've been cleaning out for the last 6 months. It is rewarding to purge. Okay, then I also included in here a ton of vintage gift wrap that, again, you know I love to sell it, but again, I have so much and I just can't get to it all. So there's a bunch in here. And yeah, it'll sell for crazy prices. There's more in there. And you can sell it on Etsy or eBay or eBay. A Swiss Army little wristlet. That's cute. It's actually really cute. And then this, it's a Wendell August handmade, like, kind of pewter, like, platter or charger, depending on what you want to use it for. That's the brand. And then, oh, okay. And then finally, this is a travel, like, jewelry holder, but it's got a really pretty embroidery on it. So that is this box, again, 40, and it's got lots of stuff, which will easily make your money back, and then some. So everybody's going back in. Everybody back in. One more box to go. Get in there, unicorn. You homeschooled your boys before it was cool? Yeah. But better at home. Yeah, I'm so excited, Pamela. And you guys, speaking of homeschooling, I did start another channel called Texas Gal Homeschools, and I just got over 100 subscribers there. And so I'm doing a giveaway. So if you're interested, then go over and subscribe to me on Texas Gal Homeschools. I think I have it on my favorites on my, anyway. Yeah, check it out. Yeah, so hopefully I won't talk to you guys too much about homeschool if you're not into it and bore the heck out of you, right? Are you having a big listing? Well, what I'm trying to do right now, Nick, is just kind of clear out my workroom. I've got a box full of stuff that I'm going to donate, and then I've been trying to get these boxes going. I've been sorting out my jewelry, just trying to really downsize it all, and it's been really, really, it's been a relief to kind of do it. Oh, yes, thank you. Hit the like button. Thanks, Lydia. Yeah, yeah. So it's been a long time coming. I buy too much. And so what did I do this morning? I went to a garage sale. Of course I did. Well, Jenny, who has the house clean out, so I love going to her garage sales. Yes, I know it's December 23rd. And I went to, there were two garage sales on her same street. What did I get? I got some silver plate for my sister because, you know, she makes the wind chimes out of like silver plate, silverware, you know. And then what else did I get? Oh, I got some wands from Great Wolf Lodge for my guys because, you know, those are crazy expensive if you go buy them there. And, oh, a ream of cardstock. So it was all useful stuff. I think I got, oh, a roll of stamps, right? She had a roll of Forever stamps for like $2. Huh? I did good. I didn't do so bad. Okay, next. Okay, so this is the last box. And this one is also jam-packed with stuff. This is a thing. I don't know what it is. Okay? It's a thing. Is it something to do with cameras? Maybe? This is a Acura. Maybe it's to do with lighting. It's got like a cool knob. No, it's like a meter. What is that? A light meter? I don't know what it is. You'll know. Anyway, so that's in the box. And then a space pen, Fisher space pen. I know it says $2. That's just what I paid for it. A Fisher space pen. Did you hear the story? I think they were trying to invent this pen that would write upside down. And then they were so excited about it. And then the Russians were like, yeah, they have this amazing thing called a pencil because it writes every which way, you know? Anyway. okay, next. Oh, it's a light meter. Okay, thanks, Nick. Bye, Peter. Hey, Kristen. Okay, so the next, I've got this little mirror. It's super cute, like so, a little purse mirror. It's still, some of these things still have the prices on it, but you know, you're resellers. Then we've got Scarface. I think he talks. Oh, he does talk. There's Scarface. Oh, boy. Can we make him talk?
All I have in this world is my balls and my words, and I don't break them for no one. You understand?
I understand. I do. Okay. Next, I have this in here is this Laurel Birch bag. If you guys see Laurel Birch stuff when you're out and about, it can go for really good money. So I know it's just a gift bag, but it's still Laurel Birch, right? Like she makes jewelry and fabric and purses and things like that too. Guess what? More brass. We got some more elephants in here. And oh, there's another elephant. And then we've got the, what are they called? The Bremen Town animals? Bremen? Anyway, it's a German thing. It's a German story. What's it called again? Bremen Town animals? I don't know. Anyway, they foil the bad guys. So that's what their story is. And then there is this part of a doorknob. But maybe you do cracks. Then we have a skateboarder dude. Can you see him? It's like a iron skateboard guy. We've got a cute little, we'll call it a critter. I don't know what it is. What do you think that is? It's not a mouse. Its tail is too short. What is this? It's not a skunk. Its tail is too short. It's chipmunk, maybe? It's got flowers. It's not, what is it? I don't even know. Okay, you'll have fun listing that because I don't know what it is. Chipmunk? Bremen Town musicians. That's it. Thanks, Hazel. I'm like, something like that. Then we've got a clown for all you clown lovers out there. Hello. And that is a pewter clown, and it is made by, I can't read it. Maybe put it up here. I can't read it still. Anyway, there it is. It's a clown. Yes. Okay, then we've got another, like, kind of worn wallet, and it's a Perry Ellis. I don't know. Do people buy worn wallets? Maybe they do. Maybe it's like a weird thing, like people buying like well-worn shoes and well-worn pantyhose. Maybe they like this because it's been sitting next to somebody's backside. I don't know. Darius, do we smell it? I don't know. I pick up wallets. Maybe that's weird. Okay. And then two, moving forward. Two of these, they're vintage measuring devices. And then you have to do this to like swirl them back in, like so. Looks like Disney. Let me find that thing again. I'm trying to see if I see any marks on it. This one? It does kind of have that look, doesn't it? Yeah. But I don't see any marks. I don't know. They may be in there, but it's like all of a sudden my eyes don't work like they used to. Lufkin is a quality brand. Oh, good, good, good. And then we've got this guy. So he is a police officer. Let me get his tag off the back. Anyway, he's a reproduction one. You can tell because of the screw. He's a not a flathead. I'm sure there's more to it than that. But he's a little bank, and he's a little policeman, and he looks serious. Okay. Then we've got these. These are floaties. I remember I got these so long ago. Wait, okay. These are, I don't know. They're like really little floaty. Or they're blow up. No, they're blow up clothes hangers. What else do we have? I think they're just like little blow up clothes hangers, like for travel. Yeah, that's what they are. There we go. Look, you blow them up. I guess so you can take them with you when you're traveling, and they lay flat in your suitcase. Or if you're really into mod stuff and you just have to have your mod clothes hanging on mod clothes hangers, you blow them up and then you hang your stuff on your hangers, right? So aren't those cool? But yeah, I've had them how long? Like probably years. He's African American, makes him. Yes, absolutely. On the police officer guy, yeah. Somebody will pick him up. Okay, so there's a number of these. I've got more in here. Like so. Oh, look, there's even a, I didn't have to do all that work. There's pop set of three inflatable hangers. Hang on, this just fell. But I think there's six in there. So, ta-da, there's that. And then we've got this crossbody purple Vera Bradley bag. And it's in really good shape. And, you know, I got it, and I kept it. I hung on to it for this long. I got rid of a lot of my other Vera Bradley stuff because purple's not a really common, not a really common one of her colors. So I hung on to it in the hopes that I would list it, and I just never did. I just never did. So there's that. And that's the bottom of that box. So that one is $40 as well. So, again, if you are interested in any of these boxes, send me a message. Everyone needs blow-up hangers. Of course they do, right? But so, you know, there are people that are really into that, like mod look. And you know they'll just eat it up. They will eat it up. this is a really eclectic box. With Scarface and all. So, yeah. Get back in there. So as I was saying, email me at texasscouttreasures@gmail.com or message me on Facebook if you're interested. And I'll get the invoice sent to you. So yeah. Are you smaller? Is that a diaper? It's like it could be used as a diaper bag. No, I'm not that small. But it's almost like a cross, like a messenger bag, like a crossbody type messenger bag. I guess you could use it as a diaper bag too. That'd be cool. Maybe it is a diaper bag. Okay. Scoot that over. And yeah, again, I have my giveaway going on Texas Gal Homeschools. So if you're interested in following our journey, homeschooling and stuff like that, check out the channel over there and subscribe. And thank you guys for coming, and I'll talk to you later. Have a great holiday. I should be back tomorrow, but we'll see. You never know. All right. Bye, guys. Thanks.